In this video, as the title says, we will see that the Sorgenfray plane, they remember that this was a real squared, is not normal. This is a very important example because it shows us that not every regular space is normal, and that the product of normal spaces is not necessarily normal. Proving that the Sorgenfray plane is not normal is not a trivial task. We will again work with a specific subset, the set L. So L is going to be the set of points of the form x times minus x for x any real number. Let's first see if we can get a topology here. Well, we're obviously talking about RL times RL, and so the Sorgenfray plane is going to have the product topology of RL times RL. And so L will have the topology induced by this one. Well, let's see what this topology looks like. The product topology is going to be generated by the basis of products of intervals in RL. So the intervals will be the element of these forms. For intervals like this, and we can have, let's say that this is x here at minus x, we can have another element like this. So when we do this product and then intersect it with L, we will get the singleton x. And so the topology that this will generate is the discrete topology. That is obviously just on the line. So if the topology is part of L, then every subset of L will be open and also closed. Okay, so that's great. We were able to understand what topology we're working with. Now let's make another drawing to continue with the problem. Now what happens if we take some subset of L? And let's call it A. Well, obviously A is in the topology and also its complement, so any subset of L will be closed. And the complement is also closed. So I have two sets in our space, A and the complement of A. Now let's say that the purple line is only going to be L minus A. These are two closed disjoint sets in RL squared. So let's suppose that RL squared is normal. So because we have these closed subsets of RL squared that are disjoint, we know that they will exist. Let's call them UA and BA open sets such that they are disjoint. Let's say that A is contained in UA and L minus A contained in BA. So what we're saying is that there will exist here in RL squared some set UA and a set BA. Let's say that BA will be the union of these two things that are disjoint. Now let's continue thinking about a particular set. We will take the set of elements in the plane that have rational coordinates, so x and y will be rational numbers. Well, it's very easy to see that the set D is dense in the Sorgenfray plane. D is going to be just a dense amount of points in the plane. And so we can think about what happens with these points in D that are also in UA. What we will do is we will create a function phi that will go from parts of L to parts of D. And the way this function will work is that it will give us for each A that's a subset of L, we know that we can do all these things that we've done so far and get this set UA, this neighborhood. So we will return, so the function will return for this set A this intersection of UA with the dense set, so that this function can be well defined. We'll say that it will give the empty set to the empty set, and to the set L it will map D. So the function evaluated in the whole line L will give us all the points in the plane with rational coordinates. So the idea will be to reach an absurd, but it might not seem very clear so far how we will get it. But the thing is, this function is injective. To prove this, we will take two different elements in the domain and prove that the images of those sets are also different. These sets, they may have intersection, but the thing is that they are different. Because they are different, we know that there will exist some element x that is in A and is not in B. And because x is not in B, then x is in B complement. And we know that given B, we knew of the existence of UB that contained B and BV that contain L minus B. And so L minus B is a subset of BB. And also A is a subset of UA. So X is in UA and X is also in BB. That means that X is an element in UA intersection BB. And because D is dense in the plane, then we will have elements D that belong here. So if D is an element in this intersection, because it's an element of PB, then it cannot be an element in UB. And so we have that the intersection UA is different from the intersection UB. But no, the intersection UB was the function evaluated in B. And the intersection UA was the function evaluated in A. We took two sets in the domain that were different and proved that their images are also different. So this proves that this function phi is injective. Well, let's now create another function, and that function will give us the absurd. This function psi will go from parts of D, but now to L. Now, D, we said, is countable because it's a dense subset, and so parts of D is the same as parts of the natural numbers. And L is the diagonal, so L is the same as saying the real numbers. So instead of thinking this function from parts of D onto L, we will think of it as a function from parts of the natural numbers to the real numbers. And this function will take a subset of the natural number, so just any index set, and it will give us in return a real number defined as 0 dot, so it's going to be a decimal, some numbers a1, a2, a3 and so on, where each of the indexes here is going to be 0 or 1. It's going to be a 0 if the index I is an element in this set J, and 1 if not. and so this function is clearly injective. If I take two different sets, then they differ in one element. And so in this decimal number, that element will give us the index coordinate that will be different for the functions of J and the other set. So now we have two injective functions. Phi goes from parts of L to parts of D, and Psi from parts of D onto L. And so we can compose these two functions, Psi composed with Phi. This could be a function from, well, first Phi, I said, was from parts of L, and then Psi went to L. So from parts of L onto L. Because these are two injective functions, this function is injective. And now that is the absurd. How can we inject parts of L onto L? That is just a contradiction. And this contradiction comes from assuming that we could actually find these two sets UA and BA. And so this is not true. RL squared is not normal. The Sorgenfray plane is not normal. And with this complicated example, we finish this video.